And this is a square root property part two. So before we learned how to square root both sides to remove the perfect square, now we're going to learn the second step. And before you do that, you have to make it look like these. So you see how it's fully isolated? We need to isolate it. So anything that's around the x squared, you have to remove. And then now, we can use our square root property. Or minus. So x equals plus or minus square root of 3. So x equals square root of 3 or x equals negative square root of 3. And there you go. So on this one, we'd have to add 6 and then divide by 3. See, it's just like solving a normal linear equation. Then you can square root. Just like that. That's all you have to do. So it's always going to be just like solving a normal equation. If you were given 3x minus 4 equals 0, you'd go plus 4 plus 4, 3x equals 4, divide by 3, divide by 3. Except now we have a square sitting there, so you'll keep going. But it's the same exact method. All right, so give that one a shot. Hit pause and try it. Alright, so you should at least be this far, and that's great if you got this. However, this little thing right here is not good. We have a radical in the denominator, and that's not good. So, we need to finish it. So we have square root of 2 over square root of 3, and we need to rationalize, which gives us radical 6 over 3. Now we can write t equals plus radical 6 over 3 or t equals negative radical 6 over 3. We want to make sure we have the simplest form, so there we go. And that's everything, but what about parentheses? So let's look at some with parentheses. It's the same thing. This right here is what we're trying to isolate. So if you look around that side, you'll see that there's a 7. That's the one we need to get rid of. So we have x minus 1 squared equals 49. Now we can take the square root of both sides, put our plus or minus. X minus 1 equals plus or minus 7. And then add the 1 to both sides. And when you add the 1, you always want to put it in front of the parenthesis, in front of the plus or minus. Leave that plus or minus 7 or whatever's plus or minus there on the far right. Okay, now we can write it as x equals 1 plus 7 or x equals 1 minus 7, which means x equals 8 or x equals negative 6. And there's our answer. So it works the same just as before, but we isolate the perfect square. So on this one, we have to get rid of the 2. And then square root it. Plus or minus. And simplify our 12. So that's 4 and 3. It's 2 and 2. So we have 2 square root of 3. Okay, and then we're going to add the 1 over. So x equals, and like I said before, always leave that plus or minus on the far right. So it's 1 plus or minus 2 radical 3. So we get x equals 1 plus 2 radical 3, or x equals 1 minus 2 radical 3. And since we cannot combine these, they are not like terms, we're finished. All right, see if you can do the last one. That's as complicated as I can make it for a video. So give it a shot. Hit pause and try it. And that's the answer you should have. We could keep going and make a common denominator and we would get this. But it's your option. I'm fine with this as an answer or this one as an answer. All right, thank you.